Welcome to the speaking module of the IELTS speaking exam. My name is Mohammed Marufiros, number 454687. And the candidate is Aman September Mola. And your number is 356989. The speaking has three parts, and I'm going to record this for the marking purpose. And I will give you instructions for each part. For part one, I will ask you a few questions to get to know you better and some questions on a general topic. So how did you get to this exam? So
firstly, I would take around a 20-minute bus trip, and then afterwards I would take a 5-minute auto rickshaw straight to the IELTS institution itself. All around, it would take around 25 minutes.
Okay, let's talk about books. How often do you read books?
I often don't read a book, but whenever I do get a book that I do indulge into, was I read the book for around 5 to 10 minutes every day.
Where do you usually buy books?
Usually I look at bookstores, especially around like my area, because in my area there's lots of bookstores that provide lots of variety, especially if I'm looking for a certain type of book.
Which type of books do you like reading?
The books that I enjoy reading the most are books that provide some sort of motivation, such as 48 Laws of Power, and then another book, for example, is Rich Dad, Poor Dad, which compares the life of a poor person and a rich person.
Which type of books do you dislike?
I don't really dislike any sort of type of books, but if I were to say, it would be like a step-by-step guide sort of book, especially like a cooking book, because I don't like following steps, especially if I was to make a certain dish, because I just like to eyeball everything and just make my own type of recipe.
What is the next book you plan to read?
A lot of my peers recommended me to get into the Harry Potter books because people say there's lots of differences, especially when watching the movie and then how it was depicted in the actual book itself.
Where is a good place to read a book?
Usually, whenever I do find time to read a book, I usually just try to go to a library, because usually a library is a place where everyone is silent and everyone is minding their peace of mind. And another place would also be a park, because I would like to feel the fresh air and just read a comfortable book.
How have reading books changed?
Nowadays, with the advancement of like technology, people are now able to just find any sort of book that they're looking forward to reading in the interweb, whereas in the past people had to go to like a library and just borrow a book.
That is the end of part one. Now we will continue for part two. I'm going to give you a topic and I would like you to talk about it for 1 or 2 minutes. Before you talk, you will have 1 minute to have your preparation. You can take some notes if you wish. This is your topic. You can take some note. It's paper and it's a pencil. Please start now. Okay, your time is up. Would you like to start now? Please.
As a university student, I think it's very important for me to purchase a laptop, because when going into university, there's lots of assignment, and using a laptop can really help accomplishing those certain types of tasks. And when I do purchase a laptop, I do plan on buying one of a high-end type of laptop, such as a Apple MacBook Air, because it is light and convenient, as well as it does provide one of the high-end and latest chipset known as the AI Bionic chipset. Some may say it's an overkill processor, but I think it's perfect for me, because I do intend on using it in the long run, as well as after my university life, I do intend on using it, as well as sometimes the laptop itself may provide either 500 gigabyte of space, or if you want 1 terabyte, and that's plenty of space for a student just like me. But when I do plan on buying the laptop, I don't plan on purchasing it in an online market, because in an online market, it's very easy to get scammed, because lots of seller, they just want to make a quick buck, and it's very easy to scam the buyer itself. As well as if you do purchase a laptop online, they do tend to mark up the price by like 20 or 30%, whereas if you do go to a showroom, then in an actual Apple showroom, then they provide lots of student benefits, as well as warranty refund, which is very important for a student like me, And if the laptop does malfunction, then I can just easily return it and get the issues fixed. But if I don't plan on, like, if I don't plan on purchasing that sort of laptop, then I think a better alternative may be iPad itself, because an iPad is convenient, as well as it can fulfill all the day-to-day tasks that I need in accomplishing.
Okay, your 2 minutes is over. I'm going to stop there, and I will take back your paper question. And now we will continue with part three. For part three, I will ask you some more questions related to the topic. Let's talk about choosing products. With so many choices these days, how do people decide what product to buy?
I think a perfect example of choosing a product may be going through the interweb. For example, if you do go to an online store, then there's lots of recommendation. For example, a smartphone. Do look at like different stores, they provide different smartphones at different price points and what you may tend to use it for.
Yeah. How has technology helped customers to select the right product?
Like I said, when you do go into like an online store, there's lots of recommendation always popping up. For example, if you do click on a certain smartphone, then underneath that, there can be lots of recommendation of other smartphone in the same similar price range.
Is this technology always beneficial?
I think in most cases it's beneficial because lots of people are trying to find the proper price range. And usually in purchasing a smartphone, it can be a quite competitive gadget to buy. That's why I think it's quite important to look into other smartphone itself.
Will the ways people select goods in the future be different than today?
I think with the advancement of technology, I think there's going to be definitely different methods of how to purchase like certain gadgets online. But in the near future, I don't think lots of things might change, because right now it's quite advanced in purchasing things online.
Let's talk about saving money. What is good advice to give to individuals for saving their hard-earned money?
I think a good advice is if the thing that you're trying to purchase is relative to what you need, then I think it's important to actually save your money. Whereas if it's just like, for example, a showpiece or something to flex or to grab attention from your peers, then I don't think it's a product that you should be looking forward to buying. Whereas if it's a product, like I said, that's important and can use in your daily need, then I think it's a good way to save and invest in buying it.
How has saving money changed in the past several decades?
I'm leaving it home, whereas nowadays people are now more likely to investing it in a bank so that there's some sort of compound interest that they earn each month.
What are the causes of this change?
I would say because of the advancement of technology, it is easy for now people to understand where their money is located. For example, if it's in a bank, people can easily transfer it from one bank to another if they are to pay any sort of fees, whereas in the past, they would just hand out the cash to the person itself.
That is the end of part three. That concludes the speaking portion of the IELTS exam. Thank you very much.